So in the cold, hard light of the day after disaster, a black and twisted mesh of metal and memory is all that's left of Weston Pier's pavilion.
Just to let you know, we'll be speaking to more eyewitnesses who can see the flames engulfing the Grand Pier.
As you can see, fire engines stretching for a good quarter of a mile.
These were some of the first pictures filmed yesterday by a Points West viewer. And look at the difference just 1 hour later.
The end of the Weston Pier.
On the 28th of July 2008, the Grand Pier experienced a fire that completely devastated the main pavilion. 2 years on, the world-class tourist attraction was open to the public. 3 years on, we seek to answer the question, is it as popular now as it was back then?
I was due to open up the pier on that day. I'd closed up the night before and I received a phone call at home, and my initial thoughts when I heard the phone call was that I was late for work, but actually it was somebody telling me that there was a small fire on the pier.
We were called at approximately 6:45 in the morning, and the call came through as smoke issuing from the Grand Pier.
I mean, the first I heard of it, I was lying in bed. I hadn't got up yet. It was almost time to go to work, and I get a text message from a friend saying the pier's on fire.
So we responded, got in the trucks, got in the appliances, and made our way at blue lights to the pier.
And I found the fire brigade cutting the bolts to the gates because they were locked, and they were dragging up some hose to see if they could put the fire out.
The gate to the pier was shut and padlocked, so we had to use an angle grinder to get through the padlock. Then we had to run hose all the way up the length of the pier.
And about 2 hours later, that whole building was on fire, and I was told that it was irrecoverable.
We were there trying to put it out for some time before we decided that it was lost, and just to fight it from a distance.
So a lot of mixed emotions on the day.
I don't think devastation comes at that point. It's shock. You can't really decide how you're supposed to react at that point. It's just shock. You don't know what to do. I was, obviously the next thing to do was quickly get dressed and walk to the pier to see it for real, to see what was happening.
I think it's very difficult to describe the emotion, but probably devastating is one of them. I mean, you have to remember that this was a Grade 2 listed building, and whether or not you're the owners of it, you in a way are custodians of it, because you're looking after a heritage asset for generations in the future.
I'd like to assure all these people that I've mentioned, as well as any others that may be affected, that we will work tirelessly to restore this magnificent structure to its former glory.
And within 3 days we had pledged to start the rebuild, and we promised to provide a 21st century pier for Weston-super-Mare.
The attraction that was built is exactly that, a 21st century modernised pier, far removed from the older, more traditional design. However, the pier's progressive design has divided the public. On one hand, it's a strong, striking attraction along the otherwise boring seafront. On the other hand, it's an overtly modern structure in a Victorian seaside town.
I like the design. I think the design is very, very nice compared to what it was, yes.
I preferred the old pier design. It was slightly different to that one, but I do prefer the old one rather to this one.
I preferred the strides one, but that is nearer the original and it's worked out very well. Strides being the other architect.
I think it's important to any seaside town. If you look at the old pier that used to be here, Knightstone Pier, people from South Wales used to come over, they used to pay a penny, and they would stay all day. So I'm not saying that people stay all day on it, but yeah, it's a nice place to be.
I was very sad when I heard about it. I'm not from here, so I've not got close associations with it, but you know, I did think of it, oh, we're out there, and so what a shame. And so then was pleased to hear about it being rebuilt and reopened, yeah.
It was sad, but we got a better pier in place of it. It was extremely sad to see all the twisted metal, but look at what we've got now.
It was a shock, it was devastating to everybody. Those who lived in Weston, those who lived outside Weston. I actually saw it come down, I was watching it, and I was gutted myself. Absolutely gutted. It was poor and it was terrible.
Gutted. My eldest son was sat on the beach in tears, he's 42. And we could see it from our window, and it was an awful feeling. And the funny thing was, I got a phone call from my friend in Sheffield who said, is your pier burning down? And I said, yes, how do you know? She said, my daughter's rung me, and her daughter lives in Australia. So, and that was 8 o'clock in the morning. So news travels fast.
Well, it's all very, very sad because it's part of almost history for Weston. I think that was sad. But so was the war, when everything, so many buildings were bombed. But everything comes together again, and it's been probably progress. Yeah, progress.
I came here a few years ago before the old pier burned down, yeah. And so coming back here, that's one of the things we wanted to see, was the pier. And it's part of the character of the place, I think, yeah.
It is. We've always had a pier in Weston, yeah, and a lot of people, they've got a lot of memories with it. They come down holidays, day trips, so yeah.
It's the only thing that really brings people in.
There's nothing there. I mean, you'd still get tourists come to Weston. You know, there are plenty of towns where they have piers that have burnt down and people still go there, but they've got nowhere to spend their money, so they arrive and they quickly leave again. The pier has always been Weston's main tourist attraction ever since it was first built, and it continues to be the main tourist attraction in Weston. There's very little else to bring people here.
Against the backdrop of that, we were actually underinsured. So we had to fund a lot of the rebuild ourselves whilst at the same time trying to recover monies from insurance companies and the like. And it has been quite a difficult process, but I would say that after the first year, once we'd engaged the contractor to build, we suddenly turned from being in quite a low morale situation to a situation where we were looking forward to the new building coming out of the ground to something new for Weston. And actually it was the first pier to be built in the UK for 52 years.
I say emotionally initially I was very upset, but I think I started to recover from that fairly quickly when it became apparent that whatever happened the pier would be rebuilt. Now there have been piers all over the country that have had fires or have fallen down, and the majority of them have either not been rebuilt or it's taken years for anything to happen. But the one thing we knew was that this pier would be rebuilt, and would be rebuilt fairly quickly. So whilst you had the initial negative reaction to it burning down, there was an immediate positive reaction that something good was going to come of this eventually.
I think that what the design process showed us and the consultation with the public was that we were on the right tracks, because actually the building that was chosen was the one that was our favourite anyway. Had that been something different, we would probably have re-evaluated what our desire would be, because the public are the people that are going to visit it. And if you don't have the confidence in what they say about the product that's brand new, then you need to take that into consideration.
My major role was probably not so much in the design of the building or the rides, but in the selection of machines for the new pier. That was an area I had a little involvement with in the past, so I had good knowledge of what machines took good money, what machines were very difficult to maintain, which were good and which were bad.
You know, 3 years down the line, would we do anything different? I'm not sure we would. I think we've gone through quite a difficult recession. We're still supported by locals. We're still supported by lots of people coming on day trips and overnight stays. And actually a recent survey has shown that over 40% of our daily visitors are new. So 3 years on, we're still doing something right to attract that percentage of visitors who are new every day.
The Grand Pier was reopened in 2010. The pier has always been part of Weston's seafront, and even after the difficult rebirth, it still remains the centre of attention for tourists and residents alike. So yes, it is as good now as it was back then.